that's, again, it was known. And now let me explain how this follows from our results. And so the proof is, first note that this P E X Q. It follows from the factorization T minus 1, T minus Q, so on. So it sort of must be. All right. And now then let's write E to the Q X Q over E. XQ. So this is our standard formula, except that I'm taking T equals Q. Then it will be written as 1 plus sum P F K, well, P P XQ of Q. But they all will be equal to 0, starting with A equals 2. So the formula will be 1 plus P Q, sorry, plus P K here, E X Q 1. And then you can then just compute so this guy and see that it is written actually equal to this Q minus 1. Okay, and similarly you can have just a standard also another generalization of this standard identity. The standard identity is that E Q to the N X Q, and this is E X Q. This is 1 plus sum K equals 1 to N. Then you have Q N minus 1, Q N minus Q, Q N minus Q K minus 1, and divided X to the K, yes. Again, people, I believe that people who were doing quantum exploring, they knew this formula, but actually it just follows from the properties of this polynomial. Right, now, and just the only thing that I know about this guide is actually the following, that how they are related to the famous Hall-Littlewood. Polynomials. again, I don't want actually to, well, to remind you what a whole little polynomial, because so if you know, you know, because then this is just explaining of property, and it says, suppose that I will write this as f of t, now is just a product, it is an infinite product, 1 minus xk t. Then this is just an infinite product. And then p fk of t is just this whole little polynomial of this special type, x1, x2, so of t. And so this is q sub k is actually a whole little polynomial which corresponding to the most primitive Young diagram, you have k cells here. So again, this is just to explain, but I would like actually to know more about properties of those guys in now, this is just basically a trivial generalization. So, assume now that coefficients A1, A2, Ak do not commute with each other but commute with x and y. So before I assumed that they were scalars, now and then in this case you can also write a formula for p f k of t. Now the only thing is that you have to take instead of a determinant you have to k 0 1 k 1 instead of this you have to take so called quasi determinant, and this is exactly what you have. So maybe then, okay, so I have other examples, but maybe I will just maybe stop here. That's actually, as I said, it's a very, it's a short note about this one. And yes.
What if your f of x was, for instance, a generating function for, say, partitions or something like
again,
that?
Again, I don't know. This is I may ask you. You know. You know, you have people who actually know how to use, you know, Maple or something like this.
Yes, very nice.
And I work just with my bare hands, sort of to speak.
And it's a very nice project. Would like to find other examples?
Yes. I believe that it was not studied before again because of this, so that there is no stabilization sort of here with this. Yeah. Those parameters, they are not stabilized.
So that's the only case with stabilized?
Yeah, so basically quantum cases, yeah. The only case where they are stabilized. But again, I don't know, but so we did not. That's a rather short. Short note.
But this is so much more general than the previous one.
This one?
Yeah. Is your proof easier than the original one?
Sorry?
Is your proof of this, sometimes we have a more general statement, it's easier to prove than the special statement. Is your proof easier than the original?
I don't, you know, that it's... It's basically the same sort of, as soon as you use this lemma, this is more or less, so the proofs are not so hard.
So, once you have a statement, it's not hard to prove.
Yes,
but to find
a harder thing.
To formulate it.
Yes, a hard thing, not hard, but so we spend some time proving this formula for roots of this guy. So that's this one. Now, and it took a couple of days for us again to believe that you can work with not stabilizing.
Yeah, it's so general.
Things, yeah, but that's. No, but again, that's a byproduct of teaching stuff.
So the Hausdorff Kanten formula.
It was considered actually as the first step towards understanding of this paper Hausdorff formula. Yes, it was. But we decided actually that this is worth publishing just this form. But then it's making Hausdorff the next plan.
No, but this project, the determinant, is a little bit like in orthogonal polynomials.
Yes.
Yes,
but again, it would be nice to. To know more about this class, but again, I don't know.
So homework for Matthew. Other
questions?
Thanks again for a great talk.